rest in. And rest is not just, well, I'm taking off today. I'm not going to work. That's not rest. But your resting place is in God. To our son that is with us today, first time. Amen. To our sister that is with us today. God bless you. Amen. We're glad that you came today. Yes. There is a lot more Zionites than at home, baby. Yeah. At home or whatnot. I only got one call, Pastor Mark.
I know.
I only got one. That was a Finney family. That's so where they that. Are.
I
the rest
one.
Of them. Okay. Yeah. I can't speak for them. But y'all know my little message. Check. They know because I told them.
You told them.
The thing about it, this rest, if you look at Genesis chapter 2, verse 2, he says it like this. Let's see. Chapter 2, verse 2. And on the seventh day, God ended his work which he had made. And he rested on the seventh day from all of his work which he had made. Here, God says he rested. That don't mean he went somewhere and sit down and didn't do anything else. That means that he ceased and desisted from creation.
That's right.
The creatorial process is outlined here in chapter 1 for us and chapter 2, and he rested. He ceased or desisted from his creative work. In other words, everything that God spoke into this earth existence, the form of it, and, you know, the desolate place, he spoke into it. He was complete with it. There was nothing left to do.
Yes.
Nothing. He rested. That is synonymous with the word Sabbath, the Sabbath. Rest, ceased and desist from the work. So in other words, we ceased and desist in our minds from the racing and the running and the everything we got to do that's so important, yes. But God.
But God.
Verse 3 says, and God blessed. Now let me show you how the enemy is tricking us. And God blessed the seventh day. God blessed your rest. When you don't rest, God can't bless it. See, your blessing comes in your resting, in your communing with God. That is the Sabbath rest that he talked so much about to Israel. Remember the Sabbath and keep it holy. Remember the Sabbath. This is an eternal covenant. It is an eternal covenant spoke out of eternity into time that is taken into the futuristic time of eternity. You see? Yo, you are blessed. He blesses the rest.
Yes.
And then he sanctifies.
Come on now.
The rest.
He
sanctifies, that is, he sets it apart from other days.
Yes.
When you spend time with God, he takes that time and he sets it aside and it is blessed.
Come on now.
Meaning that the favor of God is on your rest.
Yes, man.
The favor of God is on your time out. Because during that time, you're spending it with him.
Yes.
You're communicating with him about God, what's going on in this world. What's going on in my life? what is your will concerning my life?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Now, look. So it's sanctified. It's blessed. You rest. When we don't rest, the enemy comes in and causes confusion. When you don't rest, you open up the door for the enemy to come in and cause havoc in your life.
Mm-hmm.